Hey guys, welcome back to the Handy Tech channel. In this episode of Rental Rehab, we're at my other property and we're going to do a few upgrades in the backyard. First job, let's take care of those overgrown lawns. I'm going to be painting the garden beds, so I use the line trimmer to cut back the grass as much as possible. I followed that up with a spade, just sort of went round and pried the grass away from the bottom of those limestone blocks. Now, as well as painting the garden beds, I'm also going to be painting the pergola. You can see it's been painted before, but some of that paint had started to chip off. It's also really, really dirty and could do with a good clean. I've found over the years that the key to doing a good paint job is prep work. It always comes down to how much prep you're willing to do. And in my case, I had to get rid of some old brackets. And there was also this big crack between the limestone blocks and the concrete base of the pergola. I spent a little bit of time getting that clean, and then I had a go at filling in that crack with some quick-set mortar. And I don't know if this is the right product to use, and it didn't turn out the greatest, but it was better than what was there. I just did my best to smear it in and fill the gaps and let it dry. Then we trimmed the trees so I had good access for painting. And then I used an angle grinder with a wire wheel on it just to lift off some of the old paint and try to smooth out the areas that I was going to paint. We're going to be painting the garden beds to match the fence and the pergola that's there, and that colour is called Classic Cream. You can see we're just going around and spraying some of the areas that we won't be painting with rollers. Then it was on to the final cleanup before painting, and man, we spent a long time cleaning. We used a combination of a water blaster and some soft brushes to clean the colour bond. Then for the concrete and the limestone blocks, we used a mix of hydrochloric acid diluted with water, probably about 1 part in 8. If you didn't know, hydrochloric acid is pretty corrosive stuff, so make sure you've got adequate protection. We've got some chemical and acid resistant gloves, and we've also got some little face masks for the fumes, and we had eye protection too. Pretty much what we did was just get some brooms and some really stiff bristled brushes and went round and scrubbed at the garden beds and the concrete around the garden beds with that hydrochloric acid mix. And this is one of those jobs where it's just pretty labor intensive, but you know, if you want a good result, then definitely put the time in and do this right. What the hydrochloric acid does is really lift any of that dirt and just get in against the grime, especially mold and stuff that's built up on those limestone blocks. We let that hydrochloric acid do its work for about half an hour, then we went around and water blasted everything off. Finally, all the prep work is done and we can get on to painting. We used a paint roller with an extendable handle so you didn't have to bend so much. And also the roller type is foam, and that's so that it holds together and it's a little bit more rugged against the roughness of the concrete. The paint we used is a paint by White Knight, and it's specifically for concrete and it's tintable, so you can colour it to any colour that you want. So now you can see the paint going on. Obviously you just use a little brush to cut in the corners and then those foam rollers to spread out the bulk of the paint. It was a really hot day, somewhere in the high 30s, so there was a lot of heat stored in the concrete and the paint dried so quick. So anyway, somewhere during this time of painting, we actually bought a secondhand spa pool. I think it was $600, and we had a bunch of guys there at the time to help us lift it onto the back of the ute so that we could transport it to our house. But then began this crazy scenario of trying to lower it off the back of the ute so that we could carry it into the house, and it was just so heavy and almost resulted in the girlfriend getting squashed, but we got there in the end and it was a good feeling. And then to get it inside, we had to take off some of the carport fencing. And then one of the other boys could give us a hand lifting it into the pergola. even though the lighting's pretty poor in this video, you can see the front limestone blocks that have been painted already and just how they contrast to the old ones. And then the next day we continued painting and just did the rest of those limestone blocks. It's a little bit hard to paint those blocks because there's so many recesses, but the combination of the foam roller and little small brushes did a really good job and they came out so nice. Thanks heaps for watching this video. I hope you learned how you can paint your own garden beds. There's going to be a follow-up video coming soon, so definitely subscribe to this channel. Cheers for watching. See you again next time.
Yeah, I've sweated everything out.
You need to go.